this material will be derived to Beatrice and Maxwell-Betti reciprocal deflection. And this is the simplest important bit. And we are considering two different endpoint on the beam. Suppose this is the A and B. To find the reciprocal deflection of Maxwell for the Maxwell laws, we have to consider force FA, which is acting at point A, and FB, which is acting at point B. This is the two forces which will occur, but to have this reciprocal deflection, first we have to consider two cases. One case in which we apply force FB first and then FA. So now let FB is the force acting at point B, and due to the force FB there is some deflection in the cantilever beam, say delta BB, and at point A deflection at A due to force B. So this is the deflection, and we know that strain energy formula wave into delta. So F is the force at that point and delta is the deflection at that point. So work done due to force B equal to half into FB into delta BB plus half into, here force is 0 into delta AB. So this is the equation 1, and now we will apply force FA at point A. So when we apply this force, the deflection will increase by some amount. So this is the deflection after applying FA. So now the deflection at this point is, deflection at this point, that point due to force A, and deflection of that point due to force A. So now we will find the work done due to the force A. That is the, here is the force FA and deflection is delta AA plus, and this is the work done. This force is acting permanent now, so force into displacement, that is the work done. FB into delta BA. So this is the second equation. And now we can now consider equation case 2. In this case we will apply force FA first and then FB. So now W work done. Means I am drawing a figure once again. So in this case we are applying force FB first, and but in the second case we are applying force FA first. So the work done will be, so due to apply this force there will be some deflection. So what will be the work done? Half into, this is the deflection at point A due to the force A, and this is the deflection at point B due to the force A. So for that strain energy will be delta AA plus, that will be 0. And for, I mean applying the force B, Fv, there will be the again some deflection, and this is permanent acting, this force is permanent acting, and this is the applying gradually. So when you applying gradually, there is the deflection. This deflection is delta A due to the force V, and this is the delta A due to delta B due to the force B. So work done by A, B will be half into Fv into delta Bv plus this is the constant force that is acting. So this force into displacement equal to work done Fa into delta Ab. So this is the equation 3, this is the equation 4. Now adding this equation 1 and 2 to adding this equation 1 and 2, you will get half into Fb Abb plus half into Fa delta Ab plus Fb delta Va. Similarly, adding 3 and 4, and total work done will be half into Fa into delta Ab plus half into Fa delta Bb plus Fa delta Ab. So now in the both cases some of the force is equal, and this also to some of the force is equal, but we are applying in this case Fe is applying first and then Fa, but in this Fa is applying first and then Fb. But overall means for this strain energy will same as this case, so both equation will be same equal. So now it going equal delta A plus Fb delta Ba equal to half Fb delta Aa plus half Fb delta Bb plus Fb delta Ab. So now this we cancel out, and this we cancel out. So Ab equal to delta Ba equal to Fa into delta Ab. This is the Betti's laws and theorem. Betti's laws and law of theorem. So for now, this is the Betti's equation. So for Maxwell laws, if Fb equal to Fa, these two should be equal. So for if I'm putting this in equation 5, we will get delta Ba equal to delta Ab. So this means deflection at B due to the force A is equal to deflection at A due to the force B, and this is the Maxwell law of reciprocal deflection. Thank you. If you are finding any problem, then tell me in comment box and I will reply. I will try to reply you. So thank you.